Hey, welcome back into today's video. Conspiracy theories. I haven't done one in a long time, but I found a really good one. The kind that makes your skin crawl. The kind that you're gonna wanna tell everyone about because it's completely 100% unbelievable. But the facts check out. So this one came to me from Facebook. And I really haven't got a lot of material on Facebook, but since the Facebook page has been growing, it's the.repzilla, I'll put the link in the description, I've been getting a lot of stuff on there, and it's kind of crazy. So let me read this to you. So I'm on the Office of Congress Library website, and I came across this book written in 1893. Look at the title. The title is Barron Trump's Marvellous Underground Journey. The book is about a boy named Barron Trump who found a secret portal and time travel. But that's not the crazy part. Hashtag wait for it. Barron Trump is Donald Trump's son. Look at his face. Check this out. It really resembles the art in this book. Wow. In the book, Barron Trump had a mentor he looked up to named, guess what? Don. But it gets better. All the stuff in the book takes place in Russia. Melania Trump is from Slovenia. That's Donald Trump's wife. So, 4 years later, in 1896, the same author writes a sequel to the book, but he calls it The Last President. And this is when stuff's about to get real. This book is about a very wealthy man who lived in New York on Fifth Avenue who ran for president but wasn't expected to win. Trump Tower is on 725 Fifth Avenue, New York. Wow. This is like legit tingles down my back, my spine. This is crazy. In the book, when he won, it surprised everybody, and people started rioting and protesting, and after his inauguration, he started signing executive orders. But there's more. Remember, this book was written over 124 years ago. But anyways, after his inauguration, he started picking people for his cabinet, and guess who was one of those people? LaFay Pence. Secretary of Agriculture LaFay Pence. Mike Pence is vice president. Like, legitimately. Let's take a breath here. Get you a sip of your coffee. This is real. Like, this is real. And it's about to get even crazier. In 1943, one of the most famous inventors named Nikola Tesla died from a blood clot. Before his death, he claimed he had built a time machine and used it to travel back in time and in the future. After he died, the United States government took all of his inventions and notes the name of the office that seized all of the work was the Office of Alien Property. After they looked through it, they passed it on to the FBI. And that's a real office. Check it out. The Office of Alien Property is legitimate. You can give it a Google. You can fact check all this stuff. But check this out. I do want to go ahead and say Nikola Tesla is actually the person who made the modern light bulb that we use today and electricity that we use today. In school growing up, we were taught that Thomas Edison was the person that actually did this, but that's not actually true. Nikola Tesla worked under Thomas Edison, and Thomas Edison had a whole factory full of people that was working on these specific ideas. Nikola Tesla was the brains behind all of this, but he created crazy inventions. Like, he created something that imitated the vibrational frequencies of matter and objects, and he tested it out on a bridge, which caused an earthquake. His inventions were insane. So the fact that he had this crazy mind is not so out of the realm of possibility that he created a time machine. And if he did create a time machine, the government's not gonna tell you, but it seems like maybe Trump got his hands on that. But how? We'll check this out. After they gave up on trying to figure out his inventions, they hired an outside engineer who could understand the work of Nikola Tesla. And guess who this dude was? John G. Trump. They hired John G. Trump. I'm not joking. John Trump is Donald Trump's grandfather, but after studying the time machine, notes, and inventions of Nikola Tesla, he told the government he didn't find anything. Could he have lied to keep the invention to himself and out of the hands of the government? Fun fact, Donald Trump's mama's name is Mary and his father's middle name is Christ, and he was born on the night of the total lunar eclipse. Mary, here's the facts right here, Mary Ann Trump and Frederick Christ Trump. And yes, he was born June 14th, 1946, the total lunar oh man, like this is a lot. I know this is insane, but we gotta fact check it. Let's see if we can debunk this. So this is a fact checking article about the conspiracy theory. I'm gonna put it in the description along with the link to the actual conspiracy theory so you guys can all check it out and give me your opinions in the comment section below. It tries to debunk it, but I'm not convinced. There's some incredible connections to be made with the first family of the United States and Lockwood's novels from the turn of the 19th century. For starters, the main character's name is the same as President Donald Trump's son. Though it's spelt differently, Trump's adventures begin in Russia and are guided thanks to the directions provided by the master of all masters, a man named Don. Before leaving for his voyage through the unknown, Trump is told of his family's motto, which is, "The pathway to glory is strewn with pitfalls and dangers." But by Lockwood's third novel, The Last President, things become even more eerily linked to the present day. The story begins with a scene from a panicked New York City in early November describing a state of uproar after the election of an enormously opposed outsider candidate. The entire East Side is in a state of uproar. Police officers shouted through the streets, warning city folks to stay indoors for the night. Mobs of vast size are organizing under the lead of anarchists and socialists and threaten to plunder and despoil the houses of the rich who have wronged and oppressed them for so many years. So here's another thing I caught in my fact checking. The main character is called Barron Trump, not because of his name is Barron, but because he is a Baron. In other words, that's his title. Now, they're saying that this is a method of debunking, but I'm not so sure. Much like the Illuminati likes to hide things in plain sight, it seems like the fact that his title being Barron and Donald Trump's son being Barron and the last name Trump is really just more of like a signpost, if you will. And this does not convince me that this conspiracy theory is not real. The next thing they point out is that, so one of the characters that guided Barron through his marvelous time traveling journey, whose name was Don, or aka for Donald, they point out that Don is a Spanish honorific meaning Mister. And again, that's still not enough to for me to debunk this. Finally, the last nitpick is the Fifth Avenue Hotel, meaning that it shares the street with Trump Tower. Since Fifth Avenue is a well-known part of New York that has been the site of several high-end restaurants, shops, and hotels since the 1800s, it's saying that it's just a known place and that it would be used in books back then. But still, you can see that's not enough to debunk this for me. There's some minor differences and things like that, but still, the fact that this story is telling step by step exactly what happens is enough to send the cold shivers down my spine. And I'm really interested in what you guys think about this. I really want to know. It's really scary, not gonna lie. Do you think this is real? Can you believe this? Share this with your friends and see what they think. Tell them to comment in the comment section below. Because as interesting as it is, there's always something that's more interesting to me. That's right, you guessed it. I want to know what you think. So why don't you go ahead and leave your creative and interesting responses in the comment box below.
Thumbs up to the likes.
And as always, brothers and sisters, I will see you in the next video. This is scary. I didn't drink enough coffee for this. man. Some updates we got is I'm coming out with I'm gonna work on it right after I get done with this video. I've been working on it for the last 6 months, but I'm gonna have some new designs coming out in the merch store, and we have free shipping coming up for everything in the merch store, but it's only gonna be for a couple days. I think it starts on the 29th through the February 2nd, and I'm gonna get those new designs out so you guys can get those. And we're fastly approaching 9,000 followers on Instagram. It's the.repzilla. Definitely go over there. We're doing a Q&A. Send all your questions over there. And you can always reach out to me on DMs over there as well. That's how I know if you're repping, if you're not repping, you're gigging. And how do you do that? All you gotta do is subscribe, notifications, turn on, be in the comment section to every single video, because I'm gonna be there. Greg the Cat is gonna be there, and the rest of the Repswell community as well. And I expect to see you there too, because this channel loves you.
Oh, it's so hot.